you could please give us the layman's version of what's happening in Parkinson's disease.
So what happens is the part of the brain that deals with what we call motor function, or your movement degenerates basically, and people have trouble moving basically. It's what we call a motor disease. People have trouble with action and motion.
So let's go through the three characteristics of Parkinson's disease. Walk us through the list explaining what each characteristic is. And I guess what the basic key that we're talking about here is that motor function is huge at this point, because we start out with, first of all, before we get there, the pill rolling at rest. What is that?
So pill rolling is as if somebody had a pill between their thumb and forefinger, they would roll their fingers back and forth. So a lot of times you'll see people sitting and they're doing this with their hands.
They're doing this?
It looks like this, yeah.
Okay. So, let's go back to the graphic if you could, because I'd like to go ahead and follow that out here, because we started there. So if we can, here we go. Okay, I'm going to let you go ahead and pronounce the word.
Okay, so bradykinesia is obviously a medical term. And it's slow movement. So when you see somebody who has Parkinson's, they turn their head very slowly. They even blink very slowly. If they raise out their arm, it comes out very slowly. And it's almost like they're moving in slow motion all the time. They can't do quick, purposeful movements.
And then the other one is a rigidity and a stiffness. What is cogwheeling?
Right. So if you take a patient who has Parkinson's and you try and move their arm, it's not a very smooth motion. What you see is sort of a staccato-like movement of their arm or muscles.